Welcome to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. Really excited to be playing this. I just finished Amber Star, and now we're going right into this. Unfortunately, the last of a planned trilogy of games. Thought the last one was going to be called Amber Sun, but it's actually going to be Amber Worlds. Pretty interesting in any case, but anyway, this was released by Thalion Software in 1993 for the Amiga only, and officially in German only, right after they released the German version on the Amiga. The company folded, unfortunately. But a few years later, an English translation surfaced of a beta version. Someone who knew one of the developers was asking about it, and one of the developers had discs with the translation on it. And so a beta 1.07. So it was released on the Thalion web shrine. Never sold or anything like that. The only sold copy was the German version on the Amiga. It was never ported to any other systems. So luckily we got this little gem just in time. But unfortunately, for Thalion Software, they had gone out of business at that point. Many of the members had gone on to work at Blue Byte to basically... Yeah, they made a lot of other games. Among them... what was the name of it? A spiritual successor to the Amber Star and the Amber series. Albion. Begin this, and I am emulating an Amiga 4000 using fs-uae. It was recommended to have JIT enabled, but when I checked that little box and tried to play this, I got a message down on the bottom here that MMU emulation was disabled. Something to that lines. For the 68030, 40, etc. And I don't know if that's a good thing. So I have JIT unchecked now. I have CPU emulation set to fast as possible. This is version 1.07E, which fixes some bugs, including one where you try to go through a door or something like that, and you have to use a jump command to go through the door, otherwise the game will crash. That's supposedly, from what I see, is fixed in this 1.07E version. So, but you know, if that comes to be a problem, I'll jump through the door. The intro is pretty interesting. Hope you guys don't mind I blabber on a little about it. I really love playing Amber Star. I loved it, and I'm really excited. I think this is going to be even better. From what I heard, the map is like four times as big. And the combat animations are even slower. But I think if I press Alt-W, I can skip ahead frames. So that might be able to speed things up, I think. Obviously, I haven't tried it yet. I never tried it in Amber Star. I didn't know it existed. But I did a little research. Now, before I get into this, there's a manual where, if you guys want to pause and read this, I'm not going to read all this, but I am going to read for the benefit of those. This is the team. I'm going to read, and for the benefit of those, what happened in Amber Star, and then what happened before Amber Moon. So, this is basically, what happened in the game, or before Amber Star, and then during Amber Star. The world of Lyramion, 1,000 years before Amber Star, A young magician by the name of Tar gained power in the Guild of Black Magicians. In the final test down deep in the demonic realms, he was confronted by that powerful Lord Demon, Thornahoon, who informed him that he was his father.
Luke, I am your father.
Beside himself with rage, Tar attacked Thornahoon with all his magical power. After a long and bitter battle, Thornahoon decided that his son would not be of any use to him in that form, and developed a new plan. He entered the very being of Tar, which rendered Tar insane and made him a willing helper of the Lord Demon. From that time forth, Tar called himself Tarbos, God of Chaos, and began to lay waste to the world of Lyramion. Only the combined power of the Guild of White Magicians could stop him. He was beaten and locked away in the small red third moon of Lyramion. See the intro. The magic seal to his prison was created in Castle Godsbane, which in turn was sealed by that powerful magical artifact, the Amber Star. The Amber Star was then broken up into 13 pieces and spread over the whole of Lyramion. Okay, so that's pre-Amber Star. All this took place 10 centuries ago. Then Marmion, a black magician, tried to release Tarbos from the Red Moon. With the help of the demonic brother of Thornahoon, he teleported directly into Castle Godsbane and began to intone the long spell, which was to break the magic seal. Now, I was wondering at the end of Amber Star, I'm like, well, we got all the pieces of the Amber Star to get in here. How the hell did Marmion get inside? Because then we met up with him and Browker. I'm like, how did these people get inside? So they teleported directly inside. Yeah, very convenient that we were unable to do so. But anyway, with the help of the gray magician Chandra, a young adventurer and a group of friends located the 13 pieces of the Amber Star and overcame Marmion. Okay, so this is basically like 60-something hours compiled into one sentence. So now, what happened before Ambermoon, this is interesting information for me as well. 20 years after successfully retrieving the Amber Star, the adventurer settled on an area of land which had been presented to her as a reward for her heroic deeds. Now, Amethyst is female, that's the adventurer that I played in Amber Star. Unfortunately, the canon story of this is very similar to Fallout 2, when they are discussing the past exploits of the Vault Dweller. The Vault Dweller is male. I didn't play a male in Fallout 1 either, so I am going to change everything, including during the very beginning of the game, from grandfather to grandmother, him to her, etc., because it makes more sense with the story of Amber Star, and we're continuing here, so. Anyway. The deeds of Marmion became evident again after all those years. The God of Chaos threatened to break free. The unfinished spells had cast the Red Moon out of its orbit, and on one fateful day the moon fell on Lyramion. In great danger, the hero of Amber Star searched desperately for her daughter, and eventually was able to save the child from the chaos involved in the destruction of Twin Lake. Our character's mother, her daughter. I know, it's going to be getting confused, especially as I'm changing the pronouns around. For many weeks, earthquakes shook Lyramion repeatedly and huge volcanoes erupted, laying the land to waste. Lyramion had changed so much it was unrecognizable. The continents had broken up into small islands and gigantic clouds of dust darkened the sky over Lyramion for many years. Most of the towns and villages were destroyed completely, and of course, all trade collapsed. Our game now begins many years later. Civilization is gradually returning. Several towns have been rebuilt, and life is gradually coming back to normal. I get the sense that it's gradually happening. The hero of Amber Star survived and brought up her grandson on his own. Oh, granddaughter. Well, even in here, they're calling... Because I'm playing female in this, too. So, granddaughter on her own. But it appears her time has come. At more than 80 years of age, she is now bedridden and waiting to enter the realms of Bala, not Balas or Balas, the god of death. But before she dies, she sends her grandson on an important mission, and this is where your adventure begins. You must find out what is happening on the island of Lyramion and what risks there are to you and life on Lyramion. And that's it for that. I think there's also a novel, like a little novella, novelette, whatever, in the back of the manual, but unfortunately the manual is only in German, so I guess someone didn't want, you know, we don't have it at the end here. We have tables and stuff, so this is going to be very useful, of course. But, yeah, I don't blame that person for not wanting to translate the entire novelette, short story, what have you, in the back of the Ambermoon manual. Anyway, starting a new quest. Create your character. Oh, I hope we don't have the disc thing. I'm going to have to virtually put a disc in. Just going to look at these. That is a dead-on for Tanis. Tanis Half-Elven from... Why can't I remember stuff? Dragon... Oh my god. I've read 60 of the books and I can't remember the name. Dragon... What? Dragon Lance. My god, what is wrong with me tonight? Looks like... Yeah, Tanis from Dragonlance. In any case, on that first novel, Dragons of Autumn Twilight, I believe. That's almost as old as the grandparent. Alright, so, female. It's funny because these are all like basically the same face, but just different hair. So I'm going to choose this. Oh my. What are we going for a name? Couldn't be Amethyst again. Citrine. Yeah, pretty happy. I'm gonna... Hold on one second, guys. I'm gonna fix the disk drive noise. I did not... That didn't happen during the intro. Hold on one second. Okay. Your grandmother lies in bed before you, very ill. Her chest rises and falls slowly and painfully with a horrible rattling noise. Her eyes stare blankly at the ceiling. When he notices you, a little life returns, but her attempt to bring a smile to her lips ends in a fit of coughing. When she partly recovers, she whispers quietly, "My beloved grandchild, Citrine, please come closer and listen to me carefully. I have something I must tell you before I enter the realms of Bela." Exhausted, she closes her eyes. Okay, grandmother's house. So, I looked around the house, and other than that, this is completely blind. And you know what? For some reason... We have a border here that's cut off. I'll be right back once again. Okay, that should be better, I think. I hope. It should decrease the black bars a little on the side of the screen, and some of this stuff was cut off. It's interesting how it... I think this was the size it was when the very beginning of the intro, when the stars were, like, flying past, before you started seeing the red moon and all that. And then it shrunk. And now it's back to this. So I don't know. Anyway. So this is... Yeah, these would be whatever characters join us. Whenever that might be. and you move around like this with these keys, or with the arrows you can do. Or here I'm using, oh, that's interesting. Here I'm pressing the numerical. When I use the arrow keys, it doesn't show the presses. But when I use the numerical, it does. That's interesting. And then this passes time. And then you change here, you can actually look at stuff. Well, let's just move over. Can I... Nope. Cool. I was trying to use a numpad there and I went into camp, but I can use arrows to move whenever I want, so I'm gonna just use arrows then. Nothing to be seen here. I mean, once I get used to it anyway. Right now I'm just using the mouse again. Oh, so this is like technically a chest. Citrine is unable to pick the lock. And I think if you click the eye on yourself... Oh no, it doesn't. Used to be when you click the eye on yourself, it would bring up your stats and all that. You notice a trap! Really? I don't think I'm able to disarm that. Ooh! Okay, we got a robe. Leather shoes. Okay, we can get stats here. Not a description, I don't think. It never was in Amberstar. But you can get the basic... ooh! Here? Yeah. Sorry, I forgot about that. Where it actually tells you what the healing potions are now. So you don't have to go look at, like, this thing that I had. In Amberstar. I had to keep looking at this because I forgot which was which. It wouldn't tell you. But I guess people complain about that. Okay, so that's cool. We get a number amount. Well, we could stack. Could we stack before? Yeah, we could. Cure poison. Okay. Cool. If we right click, that happens. If we left click, we get to choose how many. So if you want all, just go like that. Okay. Unfortunately, my ragdoll thing looks like a guy. What can you do? It's a cruel world. Shield plus 4. Ooh, what classes do we have there? Adventure. Okay, I'm Adventurer 1, which basically means you have no class, right? Well, like school in summertime, no class. You got Warrior, Paladin, Thief, Ranger, Healer, Alchemist? Mystic and Mage. So I guess we got... These might be three different kind of mage subclasses or something? Specialize or something like that? That's cool. Alright. And then I got... I can go like that and move it wherever I want. I got a buckler. I can't put it there. And shoes. Now look at my... These are your life points, aka hit points. I already have 75 experience points, somehow. 17 years old. These are my spell points. These are my spell learning points. You use up this pool of points when you learn spells. TP? I'm not completely sure what that is. Gold and rations. And then here's our attack and our defense. So when we put on the leather shoes, you should increase the defense a little bit more. Yeah, 7. Sweet. Oh, and then here, okay, here we go. This definitely looks familiar. Strength, 33. This is all out of 50, except for whatever that. That should be your magic, resistance. Here it's A-M. So you're 33. I don't know if this is random when you start the character, or this is set in stone. But in any case, you have 33 strength, 27 intelligence, 34 dex, 21 speed, 48 stamina, 41 charisma, and 16 luck. Hopefully we'll raise these throughout the game. Certain points. Attack is 42 out of a possible 80%. Parry, 19. Swimming, 1. We're horrible. Crit? Is this a crit damage? Crit multiplier or something? In any case, it's 0 out of 0. Find traps. Disarm traps. Lock picking. Right? Now we get lock picking. Okay. Search. Read magic. And use magic. 50% total? Are you kidding me? We gotta get this way up. Somehow. Because in Amberstar, even if you were like 90, 95, you'd still fail sometimes. I don't want to fail anymore. What a nightmare that was in the beginning of Amberstar. Trying to learn scrolls and just fail. I would cut it out of the episode or speed it up or something. That and trying to use magic. You will fail. I will fail 3 out of 4 times. So, you picture trying to heal somebody. You try to heal, fail. You try to heal, fail. Try to heal, fail. Person dies. Anyway. So then here is your... You can drop your money. You can drop an item. You can use an item. You can look at items. You can give gold to a party member, which doesn't apply because you don't have any party members. You can give food or rations to a party member. And this is drop food, I guess? Looks like a drink, but it's probably what that is. Anyway, let's talk to is there a book up here? You see an old, sick woman. Her cheeks are sunken and as pale as ash. Her eyes are tightly shut, flinching with the light of the fire. Her breath is labored and rattles in her throat. Alright, let's talk. And this is your casting magic, but you don't know any spells yet. You could ride a horse if you had one. Camp. This is your world map, which you can't see yet. This changes your battle positions for your party members. But it's only us. And this is save. Oh, options. Oh, right. Oh, fast combat mode? Oh. Can I turn this on? It's grayed out. I don't know. If anyone's familiar with this, let me know if... I don't know if this just means it's always on, or I can't turn it on. Outline text. So what does that do? Outline text. Meaning it has this embellishment around it? The light of the fire... I think it's spaced out a bit, too. Let me just see. outline. Okay, it says the same embellishment around it, but flinching with the light of the fire, there was like more. I don't know the name of it. Sorry, guys. The fire. See that? It's justified. It's like center justified or something, whatever it's called. Middle justified. It calls it outline, though. But it's interesting, the last sentence isn't justified over. I mean, it doesn't really make much difference here. It might show up as being something. It might show up differently in another part of the game. I'm gonna keep the combat mode off for at least the first combat, and then we're gonna see what it looks like on. Because it's probably gonna be ridiculous, so we're gonna want it on all the time. Hello, Citrine. Please come closer to the bed, my beloved grandchild. My body is weak, and my voice is not as strong as before. Okay. I can show items. Give items. Give money. I do not want to join your party. Well, fine. I don't want you in my party anyway. Grandma. Age 80. Warrior 90. Forgot what I left off. It was a lot less, a lot lower than 90 though. It was like 20 something, I think, was my level to end at the end of Amberstar. Hello.
I would like to tell you a story, assign you a quest.
As you step closer to the bed to listen carefully to your grandmother, you see how her face distorts in pain, and above her head, you see the shadow of Bela. My grandma, what a long beard you have.
When I was just your age, I had a difficult life. Your great-grandparents had just been killed by marauding orcs.
Alright, great-grandparents. Okay, so her parents.
A few days after the funeral, I decided to go on an adventure. I was given my first task by the Lord Chancellor of Twin Lake, who had a small problem with his drains. When the task was completed successfully, Carwayne, the Lord Chancellor, told me that Chandra, the Grey Magician, had something he needed to do and was looking for a group of brave people. That very evening, I went to Chandra. What then happened is something you have certainly already heard in the stories and songs of the bards. But that I was the great hero is something I never told you, because I feel one should not brag about one's deeds. The reason I am telling you this now is because Chandra appeared to me last night in my fever. That misty being told me that a dark power is again spreading over the land and intends to destroy Lyramion.
She collapses in a fit of coughing, then continues.
Oh, as if the catastrophe with the third moon had not brought enough suffering and pain to Lyramion. Your beloved parents died in that dreadful disaster. I alone was able to escape from the Sea of Fire. My beloved Twin Lake was destroyed by fire and flood. But I must try to keep to the point, because I feel I have not much time left. So I will hurry to tell you the rest. So, Chandra said that the good side of our family is our strength, and he chose you to save Lyramion again. You should get started and go to New Lake to talk to him. The strange thing is just that Chandra died more than 40 years ago. When I was fleeing from Twin Lake, I saw how he teleported a large number of people to safety. Then he collapsed, totally exhausted. Either he was killed by the enormous effort he made, or by the moon when it hurtled down onto Twin Lake a short time later. But apparently even death does not stop his influence. I believe that this is no normal dream, and I also believe that something terrible is happening. For this reason, I would ask you to take on this quest, and find Chandra, go to New Lake, and try to contact him there. You should make preparations before you leave. Note the word wine, and go down into the cellar. You need the word to get past the old stone head in order to enter the wine cellar.
in the wine cellar is a switch. I should be writing this down, shouldn't I? Wine, I guess we got a puzzle mouth down there, I think they call it. Alright, a switch, which opens the passageway to the cave in the northern mountains. Alright. Switch to North Mountains. I left my old armor in the depths of this cave. You can use everything you find there for your quest. But you should bring me the small piece of amber which Chandra gave me with the words, "The Eternal Connection." Bring the small piece of amber, okay. Now go and hurry, for I see Baylor's realms clearly before me. I cannot wait too long. Oh yes, take a knife from the kitchen with you. Who knows what will have made a nest in the cave by now. Well, gee, Grandmore. Wine? I don't know anything special about that. There's in here we can type in responses. I like the font a lot more. Amber. What appears here, even though it didn't succeed. Amber Star. Oh, that it didn't keep. I don't know what you are talking about. Lord Tarabos! Grandma's a little senile. Talking about Carwin, right? No. Citrine, please hurry, for my time in Lyramion is coming to an end. I will not be able to help you any longer when I enter the realms of Bela. Please be here when the time comes. Okay, I will endeavor to be here when time comes. Alright.